Good morning, friends. In the last lecture, we basically discussed some fundamentals of thermal radiation. We discussed about black body emissive power, total black body emissive power, fractional black body emissive power, solid angle, and radiative intensity. In this lecture, I will introduce you to some basic concepts, some basic laws of radiative heat transfer. From last time, let us do one problem first, and then we will go to some other fundamental radiation laws. We discussed about solid angles in the last lecture. I will take one example on the determination of solid angles. So, we have to find out in this example the solid angle with which the sun is seen from earth. Okay. So, the sun is a distant object. The radiation coming from the sun is more or less coming from the same direction. We want to see how much solid angle sun subsists at earth. Okay. So, let us say we have this is the sun, okay, and we have the radiation which is coming to earth, okay. We want to find out the solid angle with which this sun is seen from earth, okay. So, some parameters we know, that is the distance, let us call the distance of sun as measured from earth, and this is equal to 1.496 into 10 to the power 11 meters. Okay. So, this is the sun distance from earth. Now, this distance may vary from year from day to day, but this is an average value taken over a year. Okay. This value may change by some amount from day to day, but this is an average value. Then sun is seen just like a circular disk with radius equal to 6.96 into 10 to the power 8 meter. Okay. So, the sun appears to be a circular disk with radius 6.96 into 10 to the power 8 meters. So, how do we calculate the solid angle? The solid angle is defined as the solid angle of the sun as seen from earth is defined as the projection area. So, when we are talking about projection, basically we are talking about the circular disk. The projected area will be equal to pi, the radius of the sun square, this is the projected area of the sun, divided by the distance square, the distance of the sun square. Okay. So, this will be the solid angle by which the sun will be seen from earth. Okay. So, pi times 6.96 into 10 to the power 8 meter square divided by 1.496 into 10 to the power 11 meter square. And this will be square. Okay. So, so solid angle will be equal to, when we solve this, the solid angle will be equal to 6.80 into 10 to the power minus 5 steradian. Okay. So, this is very small, very small solid angle, and that is why we can assume that all the radiation that is coming to earth from sun is basically coming in the form of parallel rays, that is, it is not having a range of solid angles, it is all basically coming from the same direction. So, because the solid angle is small. Okay. Now, we will discuss it elsewhere, why we have radiation coming from all the directions. At earth's surface, we receive radiation from all the directions, but if we go into space, the radiation will be coming from only one direction. It is because on surface of the earth, we have direct radiation coming from the sun, which is basically a parallel rays, but we also have scattered radiation from the clouds, which basically comes from all direction. So, in the next example, we will see how basically these components come into play in deciding how much radiation is received at earth's surface. But if you go into space, basically there is only one component of solar radiation that is coming, and that component is direct, and direct radiation is coming in a small solid angle. The magnitude of that solid angle is approximately 6.8 into 10 to the power minus 5 steradian, which is very small. Okay. So, that is basically a simple problem on solid angles. Now, let us go to the first fundamental law of radiation, that is the Wien's displacement law. In our previous lecture, we developed the relation for a black body emissive power in a parameterized form. The parameter was n lambda t. Okay. So, as a function of n lambda t, we discuss this function, the Planck's black body emissive power, okay, E b lambda, okay, which basically gives you the total amount of energy emitted by a black body in a given spectral range, in a given, at a given wavelength. Okay, so C1 and C2 are first radiation constant and second radiation constant. Now we want to see what is the wavelength at which the maximum amount of energy is radiated. So what we need to do is we need to differentiate this relation with respect to this parameter and lambda t. Okay, so if we differentiate this relation with respect to this parameter and lambda t and solve for this parameter for the maximum value, okay, what we get is n lambda t max is equal to 2898 micrometer Kelvin. So this is the constant. Okay, so what basically it says is that lambda t max, max means the maximum intensity, the wavelength of maximum intensity is basically constant. Okay, and this constant depends on value of n and temperature. Okay, so this constant depends on value of n and temperature. Okay, so lambda t max is equal to constant, and that is basically the Wien's displacement law. So what basically it says is when you increase the temperature, the maximum intensity appears at shorter wavelength region. Okay, so if you have a sun which is at 5777 Kelvin, the maximum intensity of solar radiation is in the visible range, and that's why our eyes are much more sensitive to visible radiation. If you look at radiation coming from some other star which is at very, very high temperature, the radiation intensity will be shifted towards shorter wavelength, and we see that at many stars basically they have radiation intensity peaking in gamma rays and other short wavelength range spectrum. The second important law of radiation is Kirchhoff's law. Okay, now Kirchhoff's law basically gives you a relation between energy emitted by a surface and energy absorbed by a surface. There are many, many variations of Kirchhoff's law, but this one basically relate to the law of Kirchhoff's law to black body. What it basically says is a black body, as we have already defined, absorbs maximum amount of radiation. In fact, it the way it is defined, it absorbs all the radiation that falls on it. Okay, so that's what we define black body. So black body absorbs maximum amount of radiation. Other bodies, they absorb radiation but less than the black body. What Kirchhoff's law says is that the black body also emits the maximum amount of radiation. So a black body, maximum amount of radiation is absorbed as well as maximum amount of radiation is emitted. Now how do we prove it using Kirchhoff's law? So let us say we have an isothermal enclosure. Isothermal enclosure means that this enclosure is not receiving any energy, not giving any energy. It is completely in thermal equilibrium. That's why it's called isothermal enclosure. Inside this isothermal enclosure, we have a black surface. On the left hand side, there is an enclosure where we have a black body. And on the right hand side, there is an enclosure, an isothermal enclosure where we have a non-black body. Okay. Now this black body and this non-black body, when left for sufficient amount of time, will be in thermal equilibrium with the enclosure. That means the temperature more or less will be equal to the temperature of the enclosure. So after some time, they will be in thermal equilibrium. Now the amount of radiation that is coming onto the surface from this enclosure. So radiation is emitted from this enclosure and it travels towards this surface, this body, and it will be absorbed by that body. Okay, so black body absorbs maximum amount of radiation. Okay, now if it does not emit maximum, the same amount of radiation or the maximum amount of radiation, its temperature will increase. Okay, while the non-black body receives less amount of it receives same amount of radiation, but it absorbs less amount of radiation. So it definitely has to emit this less amount of radiation, otherwise this temperature will decrease. Okay, so by this analogy we can say that a black body receives maximum amount of radiation, that is absorbs maximum amount of radiation, it simultaneously emits the maximum amount of radiation to keep this body in thermal equilibrium. Similarly, a non-black body absorbs less amount of radiation compared to a black body, and similarly it emits less amount of radiation compared to a black body. So this is basically the Kirchhoff's law. Okay, so it basically gives you the relation between emittance and absorptance of a surface. Okay, we will come to this in the next lecture. Emittance and absorptance of a surface are related. The more a surface absorbs, the more a surface emits. So that is basically the corollary of Kirchhoff's law. Okay, so now the intensity leaving a black body. Okay, we introduced this in the last lecture. So the important point, now this can be proved using Kirchhoff's law. What basically we know about black body intensity is that it is isotropic or diffuse. That means the intensity leaving a black body is same in all direction. Okay, a black body emits and emits equally in all direction. So that is what basically we called a black body. Okay, although it is not practically true, because no red body can emit radiation in this direction, that is parallel to the surface, but still for theoretical purpose we assume that a black body is isotropic, that is it emits equal amount of radiation in all direction. Okay, so that means intensity of black body does not depend on two angles, theta and psi, that is polar angle and azimuthal angle, because it is equal in all direction, it means it does not depend on theta and psi. So what we can do is the total MSC power is equal to intensity. Okay, the total MSC power we define is intensity, projected area cos theta, and then solid angle d omega. So this is d omega, this is for the projected area of unit magnitude. Okay, and the intensity, and we have to integrate from 0 to pi and 0 to pi by 2. Okay, so 0 to pi and 0 to pi by 2, basically they define the solid angle 2 pi over a black, over a flat surface. So 0 to pi and 0 to pi by 2 is the total solid angle over a flat surface. Okay, now intensity is basically independent of theta and psi, so we can take this quantity out of the integral here, and what we are left with cos theta, sin theta, d theta and d psi. So when we integrate this quantity we get pi. So that means the MSC power of black body is related to intensity of black body by this relation. So the factor is basically pi. Okay, many times you confuse that total angle is 2 pi, why should not be the MSC power be equal to 2 pi ib. Okay, so just you have to keep in mind that intensity is defined normal to the rays. Okay, the area, projected area is normal to the rays of travel of intensity, and that is why this angle pi appears here. Okay, so black body MSC power is equal to pi times the black body radiative intensity. So okay, now we will do one more problem. So in this problem what we will do is we will discuss solar energy reaching the earth. Okay, we have to find out how much energy is reaching the earth. Now what we have been given is, as we have known, that in extraterrestrial space, that is outside the atmosphere, we only have direct component of radiation, all coming in single direction. But at the surface of the earth we have diffuse radiation, that is scattered from atmosphere. This radiation comes from all directions. Okay, and this could be isotropic, it could be non-isotropic. Okay, now on a clear day the direct solar heat flux is determined to be 1000 watt per meter square. Okay, normal to the rays. Okay, the intensity of diffuse component is also found to be 70 watt per meter square, and it is uniform in all direction, that means it is diffuse. Now we have to determine total solar irradiation on a surface if the sun is inclined 30 degree from the normal. Okay, now we will see 30 degree, what is 30 degree from the normal. Okay, okay, let us solve this problem. Okay, so we have this is the surface, the solar radiation, direct solar radiation is coming at an angle that makes an angle of 30 degree from the normal direction. Okay, so solar radiation is coming at an angle of 30 degree from the normal direction. Okay, now this normal direction will definitely change over the duration of the day, but at this duration the theta is given as 30 degree. Okay, now there is a, so this is the direct component, direct solar radiation, and its value is given as 1000 watt per meter square. Okay, this value is given as 1000 watt per meter square, that watt per meter square is normal to the area of rays. Okay, that is it is normal to the rays that is coming in. Now there is another component of diffuse, so diffuse radiation comes from all sides, so diffuse radiation comes from all sides. Okay, and it has equal intensity. Okay, and the value is 70. So this has equal intensity in all direction. Now we have to find out how much total energy is basically reaching the surface. Okay, so total energy reaching the surface Q in will be equal to Q direct plus Q diffuse. Okay, so Q direct will be equal to Q sun. Okay, the solar radiation intensity 1000 watt per meter square, and this angle cos theta. Okay, this theta is the angle made by the solar radiation from the surface, normal direction. So Q lambda, sorry, Q sun cos theta, and Q diffuse. Now you will have to integrate it. Okay, so this will be equal to, we have to integrate it over all the angles. So this will be equal to integrate over angle 2 pi d omega Q diffuse cos theta. Okay, because we have to find out the normal component. So energy will be the normal component of the Q diffuse. Okay, it is coming from all direction. Definitely this component of Q diffuse will not contribute to any flux, right, while this will contribute more, right. So we have to find out all the components, and we have to integrate over the solid angle. So this will be equal to 1000 cos 30 plus, now we have to we write d omega again as sin theta d theta d psi. Okay, so 0 to 2 pi, 0 to pi by 2, that basically defines the hemispherical solid angle above the flat surface, cos theta sin theta and d psi. Okay, and we already know that this is value will be equal to pi, so we have to just multiply by Q diffuse here, Q diffuse. Okay, so this Q in will be equal to 1000 into cos 30 plus pi Q diffuse. Okay, so this will be equal to 1000 cos 30 plus pi and 70, this will be equal to 70 watt per meter square. So this value will be equal to total 1086 watt per meter square. So total amount of energy received from the sun will be equal to 1086 watt per meter square. Okay, so this is how basically you can use the direct and diffuse component of the radiation. Okay, thank you very much.